Welcome to this video on parametric and non-parametric models. After this video, you will be able to describe parametric and non-parametric models. You will be able to explain the limitations of parametric models and the need for non-parametric models. You will also be able to list the pros of choosing non-parametric models over parametric models. When it comes to trading options, a reasonable price for each option is something that most traders look for. And to get an idea of the reasonable price, researchers have introduced various models, among which the Black-Scholes model is the most widely used model. However, the Black-Scholes model works around certain assumptions. It assumes that the risk-free rate and the volatility of the underlying asset are known and will remain constant until the option expires. No dividends are paid throughout the life of the options. Markets are random. There are no transaction costs. The option can only be exercised at expiry, in other words, all options are European options. And the returns of the underlying asset are normally distributed. You may have noticed that most of these assumptions will not hold true in the real world. For example, one of the assumptions is that volatility will remain constant until the maturity of the options contract. So according to this assumption, the volatility curve would be a flat line. But in the real world, that's not the case, and the volatility curve is instead in the shape of a smile. To overcome this limitation, extensions of the Black-Scholes model such as the Derman-Conney and Heston model were developed after taking the volatility smile into consideration. The Cox-Ross-Rubinstein model was developed to estimate the price of an American option. This overcomes the limitation of the Black-Scholes model, where we can only estimate the price of a European option. Similarly, multiple extensions of the Black-Scholes model were developed to overcome one assumption or another. All of these traditional models have a definite set of parameters and are also referred to as parametric models. But each of these models was bound by certain assumptions or limitations of its own. Hence, parametric models cannot be expected to capture all the relevant features of the pricing mechanism. For solving this problem, James Hutchinson, along with a few other researchers, tried to explore a non-parametric approach for predicting options prices using machine learning. And from this point onwards, the machine learning approach was widely used for pricing options. Machine learning models can either be parametric or non-parametric. But most of the research papers on this subject have concluded that the non-parametric ML approach outperforms the parametric approach when it comes to pricing options. What differentiates non-parametric models from parametric models is that these models do not have a defined set of parameters. Let's take a look at how the machine learning approach works. The machine learning approach involves selecting features that hold important information and use these features to predict the estimated price. We will split this data into train and test datasets. Then train the model to map the option prices to the input parameters using the train dataset. Finally, we will test the trained model on the test dataset. To summarize the concepts learned in this video, let's do a quick comparison between parametric and non-parametric models. When it comes to parametric models, the scope for improvement is limited as they have a defined set of parameters. Whereas non-parametric models can be improved continuously by modifying the features. But this can also cause the training time of non-parametric models to be longer as there are various parameters to consider. Parametric models are trained faster due to their limited set of parameters. But they are also bound by certain assumptions. On the other hand, when it comes to non-parametric models, assumptions can be reduced or eliminated entirely in order to improve the model's accuracy. That was all for this video.